when it was time for me to come into the banquet room, I saw men dressed in tuxedos, but the women were dressed very immodestly. I sat down at a table and bowed my head so that people really couldn't make out that I was there. I had my back to the camera. And then when it said the award for best choreography, it was to the underdog lady. I've told people many times, anyone who calls me underdog lady gives themselves away as having learned the term from its originator, Howard Stern. Mm-hmm. But here it was. I had won this this pornographic award, and I made a fiery speech saying I was not accepting it and going into graphic detail the tricks played on me by the showmakers and the indignities I suffered as a result.
Suzanne, was that speech extemporaneous, or did you prepare the speech?
Well, it was partly prepared and partly improvised.
Okay. I've been transcribing it, so would you take a look at it and read it so that you know, people could understand? So, because I think that part of it seemed like it was edited, but I'll explain which part that I saw. So, just look at the camera and give it a try. What year was this? Did you say
1992.
1992. Okay, so.
Okay. I thank you for calling me up here, but I'm afraid I have some very unpleasant news. I cannot accept this award.
The events leading up to this presentation have been nothing but disaster. I'll tell you what. When I was first asked to be on this program, I had no previous knowledge of it.
I had some qualms when I was told that it was going to be a comedy show, because I am dead serious about my performing in general, not so much this particular characterization.
So when I came to the studio, I was profoundly shocked by the norms of this program, the rude exploitations of every guest. Howard's challenging them into battles of wits and confrontations for rudeness's sake. The obscene language.
We have far too much of that in the world. Panelists and questions exemplifying the worst of human vices.
The skimpily dressed women assistants, such as these two.
Commercials for erotic code 900 phone lines. And the worst of all, the incessant use of sexuality and sexual explicitness. Improvising or borrowing anything for the sake of vulgarity and profanity.
That is just downright evil. Why was this all done? For humor, amusement, big ratings?
The only justifiable ratings for a program like this are R and X. Well?
Among strangers, I have been the target of street mockery, smear campaigns, lewd proposals, and repetitions of obscene questions originally asked by either Howard or an assistant.
And among children no more than 12 years old.
Since the Underdog cartoon show has not been rerun in a number of years, these impressionable children, 12 and under, were hearing about Underdog for the first time.
But due to Howard's antics, his assistants and other guests,
constituting what he himself termed a sea of debauchery around me, these impressionable youngsters were hearing words like Ku Klux Klan, homosexuality, orgasm, lesbianism, making out for the first time. What kind of example is that to set for impressionable youngsters? You better think hard about that, because now it's been irreparable damage. Those youngsters think that the Underdog superhero cartoon character and me are a couple of sex fiends, lustful cats. And this isn't funny at all. Among more intimate acquaintances, I've been given the evil eye because of Howard's methods. Among my immediate family, I've become his disgrace. At work, I have been pummeled to death about it, and my salary has been drastically reduced.
certainly my performing situation has not improved. It has gotten worse. Now where do we stand next? Certainly a program like this
is totally unacceptable for if Underdog, the cartoon TV superhero, family-oriented, is to be showcased in the future with respect.
What is to be done now, both in my case and generally? What I have told Howard before, and what I'm urging viewers, radio listeners, and
anyone who's opposed to his message to tell him to do and what he must do, clean up your act!
Clean up your act! Because this is an evil program!
Get rid of all the aforementioned media toxins. That's what they are, media toxins. They pollute the consumer's minds as surely as any addictive drugs, considering they are far worse evils than any villainry committed by a fictional supervillain. Howard Stern and his deeds are real!
You, Howard Stern, are responsible for all of this! Do not waste and abuse the future. You have polluted the past, and you are still plaguing the present. Stop it at once!
Wow.
Now there was part edited out when I pointed right at Howard Stern and said he was responsible.
That wasn't there in the footage.
Not in that paper.
Uh-huh. So it was edited out. So this is verbatim what it said on the television show. You had written more, but it was not used.
I had written some of it, but other parts of it I just improvised to stress my point. Mm-hmm. Or because it was so obvious how corrupt a program it was and how corrupt Stern was.
Right. Do you have the original script that you wrote?
I think I do in one of my scrapbooks, but it's not. But it's not a whole formal speech. It's just guidelines, uh-huh. Notes.
So, Suzanne, you're autographing your Stern rebuke? Okay. Anything you want to add to that, or just your autograph is fine
enough? Just the autograph.
Okay.